Hey guys, in this clip I'm going to show you how to use this camera, the JVC GY-LS300, to stream directly into YouTube. Once you've set it up, you'll be able to stream directly just using this. No external hardware, no capture cards, no laptops required, nothing whatsoever apart from the camera, because this particular camera, which happens to be a great little camera in my opinion, has the encoding functionality built directly inside of it, which is a fantastic asset to have right now, especially at your fingertips. So you won't need a PC, a laptop, a capture card, anything else once you've set it up for the first time. You just need to have connection to the internet. As long as that connection is fast enough to allow this camera to stream its output, then you can go live anywhere from your home or, in theory, any place in the world. Now, you may want to stream to Facebook Live or to Twitch, and with this camera right now, you can't do that. There's a firmware limitation. However, there is a workaround that I'm going to show you involving Restream.io. The great thing about that workaround is that it's free, it's relatively easy, and once you've set it up, if you choose to use that method, then it offers you a distinct advantage. And again, once it's been configured just the one time, you will then be able to go live, not just to YouTube, but to Facebook and to Twitch, and all three at the same time, if you wish. So let's go and see what it's all about. Now, we will talk about specific formats for streaming later on, but just be aware that you cannot access parts of the menu relating to streaming if the camera is currently set to record at 4K, HD plus web, or at 24p. So if you're in any of those formats, it's probably best to change them into something like standard HD now. Similarly, and this is fairly obvious, I guess, the camera will not allow you to initiate the start of a stream until you've made a network connection. So let's look at that first. The camera's got a dedicated host terminal to make the network connection. It says clearly in the user guide that you should only connect or disconnect an adapter with the camera switched off. So we'll set the camera up with a wired connection first. I'll just simply connect the USB to network cable adapter into that terminal. Now, I already had this Ugreen USB 2.0 network adapter and it worked fine. However, when I tried this USB 3.0 network adapter, it didn't work with this camera. Just be aware. So once your camera is connected, turn the power on, enter the menu, scroll down to System, and then scroll down to Network and make sure that's switched on. As an aside, when the network is on, but no network connection has been established, the network icon on the flip-out screen is yellow. Returning to the network menu, enter its settings option. Then connection setup. And from there, just enter the wizard. The camera is going to sense that you have the Ethernet cable plugged in, so just press next. Now here I found the JVC user guide quite vague because I have no idea what DHCP means. I'm not a network engineer. However, manual I couldn't get to work. I used DHCP. I've never used an FTP proxy, so obviously my choice is no proxy. If your situation's different, you'll have the other choice. That should be it, and the main network symbol should change from yellow to white to show that a network connection has been established successfully. Now, with the network established, press the status button on your camera, navigate to the network tab, and notice that your camera's IP address is now displayed. Note down this information, don't share it. Within the main menu, go back to network settings and enter web. Make sure web access is switched on, and you'll need to note the login name and password. By default, these are shared by all LS300 cameras. Before we move on, let's talk about getting the camera to connect wirelessly to a network. When I first looked into this, I already had this TP-Link network adapter, which I've used with my laptop in the past, and thought that would do the job. However, although it obviously fits the USB terminal on the camera, I just couldn't get it to connect to the network. Then I did realize that JVC do state quite clearly in the user guide that you do need to check compatibility of specific Wi-Fi dongles. That information is available on the JVC product website. The document is very comprehensive and broken down by geographical areas, and although I couldn't find an exact match in terms of manufacturer, the key information is the chipset used within the Wi-Fi dongle. That's the information I then use to find something on Amazon. This is the product I went for, which uses the exact chipset listed in the document. Reasonably priced, and I can confirm that it works fine. Now, it's June 2020 as of recording, and JVC make a point of saying that manufacturers changed their specification, so it is worth checking that document for any updates in the future. With the dongle inserted, power on the camera. Again, you're going to navigate to the network connection setup wizard, which now recognizes that you're trying to connect wirelessly. I'm simply trying to connect to my home network via my router, so we'll connect via access point. After forcing it to search, it should display all the available access points, including the router you're after and anything else that's visible to the dongle. You'll select the access points you want and will then be prompted to enter the password. After inputting that, I chose DHCP as the IP address configuration and pressed next. After it connected, I chose no proxy to complete the setup. As before, on your flip out screen, the network symbol should go from yellow to white. So the camera is now connected to a network, in this case via a network cable, and now we just need to live stream whatever it's pointing at, and we're going to start with YouTube. We're going to take the camera's IP address and put it into a web browser, which is going to take us to the camera's web page, which is a JVC portal. Put the username and password in. This is the camera's web page, which deserves a clip of its own, to be honest. But for now, we're going to concentrate on the settings and live streaming tab. There are four different live stream destination servers you can populate and save. I'm going to set one up for YouTube. To do this, you'll need information from your YouTube channel by logging in and going to YouTube Studio. The most important information is the stream key, and the most important thing about that is you must always keep that secret. First, I need to define which server type I'm going to live stream to. There are five different options in the portal. Looking at YouTube Studio, I can see the server URL begins RTMP, which gives me the answer. So I'll copy that server URL. I'll select RTMP in the portal, and then I'll paste the URL from YouTube into the URL field. Next, from YouTube Studio, I'll reveal, copy, and then paste the stream key into the JVC camera portal stream key field. I can then go ahead and save that. Now I'll go ahead and rename that server so it makes it very easy for me in the future when I'm looking just at the camera and I can verify quickly the server. The final thing is to make sure that I've made that server I've just created the default destination for the live streams. I'll do that by selecting it and saving it. And then afterwards I can confirm that by the fact it has a tick next to it. And once we've done that, we can actually leave the web portal. We don't need it anymore to live stream straight from the camera to YouTube. Note, if you want your live stream to have a specific title and any other particular information, and you probably do, you need to put that into YouTube before you start the live stream from the camera. You can't put that in from the camera. Before any kind of live stream, it's always a good idea to check the transfer speed you're going to have available. The key thing is the upload speed. On this occasion, I've got over 50 megabits per second, which is ample. The camera gives you a lot of options in terms of streaming bit rates available. However, just be aware that the highest bit rates are only available with certain destination server types. A good rule of thumb is to always leave plenty of headroom in the upload capacity. Don't take it to the maximum. It's always better to be at a lower resolution but stable than set the camera for a higher resolution and risk breaking up. In my situation, 1280 by 720 25p at 5 megabits per second is a good compromise, but your situation could be different and you can obviously take a different view. The streaming bitrate can be changed in the live streaming set menu. Notice as well here you can change the server, assuming you've set up more than one. That can all be done in camera. That's very convenient. And after that, all you have to do is start the live stream by switching it on. On the camera's LCD monitor, you'll see this symbol. And momentarily on YouTube, you should be going live on your channel. I really do admire this functionality. As live stream becomes more and more important, you can go straight from this camera, no capture cards, no PC once you've configured it, and you can use lenses, ND filters, great audio through your XLRs. It's just really, really powerful. I think it's well worth assigning a custom button for the live stream start stop. That's under the user switch set menu, and you can assign any one of the available user buttons to it. Number 7 seems to be quite popular. By default, that's usually an additional record button on top of the camera. But I agree, that's quite a good idea to make that the custom button to start stop live streaming. So let's look at how we can get the camera to stream into Facebook Live. On first glance, it looks like you should be able to do it. There's a URL and a stream key. And in the camera portal, it looks like that URL should match the RTMP server type. But that's wrong. It actually says RTMPS. It's a different protocol. I didn't notice until afterwards. The result is, although you can put the URL in, the stream key won't physically fit in the stream key field in the JVC portal. I just couldn't get it to work. Fortunately, I got in contact with a Facebook group. I got some really good pieces of information from some of those members, including the suggestion that I should try restream.io. Basically, Restream is a service whereby you send a stream to them and then they relay it to various platforms. I've only signed up for the free version, so it's worth noting you can only associate one YouTube channel with that. You can only go live to your personal Facebook page, not a group or public page. But it does work absolutely fine with OBS if you use that. Overall, I found it very straightforward. Once you set up the account, you simply add channels by that tab, give the appropriate permissions, and it's kind of automated. One big advantage of Restream is that you can simultaneously go live to all your connected platforms. Conveniently, before you go live, you can change the titles and description for all the platforms you're going to stream to at the same time. So once you've set up your network, set Restream as your new destination server with the URL and stream key they provide with that account, you can go live. One of the things I do like about Restream is that you can monitor the incoming feed from the camera before releasing it to your platforms. On this occasion, I've already toggled on the relay to Twitch and YouTube, but I could have just been monitoring it in Restream for 10-15 minutes just to make sure there was no problems before going live to the public. Overall, I've been really impressed with Restream. However, I have had a few problems going from Restream into YouTube. That's nothing to do with the camera. There's some sort of glitch with Restream to YouTube, which I may talk about in a future clip. But in terms of providing a mechanism for me to get the camera to live stream into Facebook, Restream has absolutely provided a solution. So I've got no complaints on that front. So hopefully you found that useful. If you did, hit that like button. Of course, any questions in the comments below. If you're interested in live streaming using just mobile phones, free apps and OBS, have a look at the clip that's on screen. And if you're just interested in creating better content, that's what this channel is all about. So consider subscribing.